Stocks are, the market continues to be down about 0.25%, although marginally better in the last few minutes. P. Goyal has written to us from Gujarat. He has over 500 shares of Ashok Leyland at 110 rupees and wants to know what should be her strategy at the moment. China on Ashok Leyland, with a buy price at 110 plus, what should the investor do? Do they remain invested? Bite the bullet, look elsewhere?
I continue to hold the stock. I have been holding it, and I believe that at current levels there is a sort of bottoming out. The numbers for the month of Feb were not very good, I would say, in terms of volumes, except the LCV segment, which did reasonably well. The HCV is not really doing, has not done well for Ashok Leyland. But if you're willing to hold it for a 2-year period, and you look at the guidance that is coming in from, has come in from the management, we are looking at a 20% type of growth coming in the next 2 years. If you look at the market share has improved in the last 1 year, and I believe that this is likely to continue over the longer term period. The whole this whole last couple of months has been difficult for the overall auto segment because of problems in liquidity, the problems that are faced by the the NBFCs, and the implications it's having for some of these MCV like the large companies. But I think to an extent things should stabilize over the coming period, and as we move from towards BS6 and the demand coming in FY20, things should look much better. So the investor should continue holding. I definitely am.
All right, you are. That's the disclosure coming in from Shahina Mukadam on Ashok Leyland. Remember, the stock has corrected about 45-46% and currently in the auto space trades at around 13 times, which is slightly more only as compared to Tata Motors and the other stocks trading slightly higher at higher valuation multiples than Ashok Leyland. With that, we move on to another query. We have Sanskriti A, who writes to us from New Delhi, holds about 2,800 shares of Tata Global Beverages at 164 rupees for the last 4 years. She's a long-term investor, wants to know whether to hold or sell. Prakash, you know, Tata Global Beverages for the longest time did nothing, then moved higher towards levels of, I remember, upwards of 250 to closer to 300. And from then has seen consistent selling. Financially has not done too much. Technically, what explains Tata Global Beverages, if one has to?
I'll tell you what, from 140 zones, it went to around 320 zones.
Yep.
It was a parabolic rise. When you see a parabolic rise, you see a parabolic fall as well. So what we are seeing thereafter is a parabolic fall. Only thing is that what we have some kind of a comfort to get into is there's a strong support in the vicinity of 170. Now it's trading at 195 or so. So even if it drips down, I don't think it's dropping much lower. Perhaps 140 or 150 could support hold. So this is not the place to sell, whatever, but book loss, continue holding it. If it dips down, keep adding it, because finally it will go up because the trend has not, and it is stretched on the downside on the technical fronts. So I feel unstretching would take place, or a bounce back would take place. If not a bounce back, at least falling would be sluggish. Yeah. So hold on, hang on.
Okay, up next, and this is quite interesting because despite how much we've spoken about PC Jewelers in the past, and it should come as no surprise really to investors what's going on with the company, but nevertheless, we continue to get inquiries from investors talking about PC Jewelers. And here's another one. Pooja Sarda has written to us from Singapore. She has 5,000 shares of PC Jewelers, which she has bought at 80 rupees. She wants to know what she should do. So she's just bought it about 3 months ago. She calls herself a medium-term investor. But, Shaina, I don't know what is the compulsion for investors to actually jump into stocks where the news flow is already negative. But nevertheless, perhaps hoping, to come in and make a quick buck. But nevertheless, what would you tell these investors, and especially Pooja in particular?
I believe that if one is really looking to be a contrarian and buy at dips and buy at some negative news, which I personally am, but I focus on the management quality. If you're trying to buy it on, a big negative news and buy it on a major correction, better to stick to well-run, well-known managements who have shown that there is a level of corporate governance. Now, unfortunately for PC Jewelers, that doesn't exist. So I wouldn't be trying to catch a falling knife and such type of stories. Secondly, even if you look at core numbers, if you look at the core earnings, if you look at the financial performance also, it is deteriorating. So I don't think that a correction in stock should be utilized to buy. Rather, I think any upside or any rally should be utilized to sell. I would just sell out of PC Jewelers and switch.
All right, sell out of PC Jewelers. Sumaira, you know, you were talking about how we keep talking about people investing in these. She can buy jewelry instead. Okay, yeah, fair point there. But definitely not from PC Jewelers or from
PC Jewelers. Sell PC Jewelers and buy jewelry.
Okay, cool. Shahina made a valid point on the management quality. Just the last 1 year, if price is something to go by, PC Jewelers is down, 76.5% as the chart will tell you. On the flip side, you have Titan, where people say that this is expensive, but quality comes at a price. And Titan over the last 12 months has gained about 30% despite trading at multiples upwards of 35, now around 40 times FY20 earnings. So yes, quality comes at a price, and Titan, you have it up 30% in the last 12 months as against PC Jewelers, which is down 76%. With that, we slip.